Hello, this is Olaf. Welcome to the third online meeting of the EMP 1 course at CREA. And this will also be the third course on remixing. In the first week, we had a look at how you can sample certain parts out of your song that you want to remix and get them into Ableton. We talked about warping. In the second part, that was last week, we had a look how you could work creatively with these loops, how you could transform these samples into drums or chop them up in drums, those kind of things. And we set up a little structure here in this view with a few different parts of the music that we could play after each other. That's what we did last week. And today we will go on with that. Today we're going to find out how you can move from this screen where you work with a loop. If you play your parts here, you can play them forever as a loop. But how can you transform this loop into a song in the other screen here? So that's what we're going to do today. So the goal of today is, and that's also the assignment for you. I don't like the word assignment because I hope it's just playful, but the goal of today is to show you how you can move from this screen with a few loops to here, where you can build a part of a song or a whole song. That's up to you what you want to do this week. Take it as far as you can take it. If you have never done it before, well, aim maybe at making 2 minutes of music. You know, try to do that first. But of course, you can take it all the way and build a whole song after this meeting. Yeah? So first, to build a song, you kind of need to know what it is that makes a song tick. So what is the song? What's the structure of a song? How do you build a song? And let's first look at a pop song. So how does a pop song work? A lot of times, when you look at a band, for example, or a singer-songwriter, they start with the intro. So imagine a singer-songwriter. First, they play a few chords or a riff on a guitar. Then they start singing. So then they start with the first verse. And after that, let's also give the color. No, let's do that later. After that, they go into the chorus. So that's chorus number one. So intro, they start doing the first verse and then they move into the chorus. You can also think about the Beatles, this classic band, this iconic band. They were very strong in working with this structure. So first the verse, then a chorus. And after that, it's very easy. You can just edit and you can copy this. And then you go there and you say paste. And then it's the second verse. So this copy pasting, I'm doing this on purpose because I want to show you that if you make a pop song, there is some copy pasting there structure wise. So don't hesitate to also do that in Ableton. If you have something which works and you want to repeat it, just copy paste it. So the pop song goes from the verse to the chorus to the second verse, which is a repetition of the first one. Maybe there's a little variation. Back to the chorus because we want to hear the chorus. The chorus is the key to the song. And then we kind of heard it enough for a while, so we want to break out of it. And that's the break or the bridge in a pop song. Yeah? So you break out of this structure, something else. And after that, the audience is longing to hear this chorus one more time because you break out of it. You broke out of it. So then you want to hear it again. So then you give one more time the chorus, third time, and then afterwards you can do like an outro. Yeah. So this is the iconic structure of a pop song. So yeah, probably you've seen it before. If you haven't, yeah, try to think about it. This is what makes a song tick. This is why we like it. We have an introduction. Then we have the verse, which is you can tell a story, and then you go to the chorus, which is the core of your song. Then you go back to telling the story and you come back to this chorus. You hear it again, it's repetition. Then you break out of it because you heard it twice. And then you start to long back. You want to hear it again because you are not hearing it anymore and you know it's coming back. And there it is. Yeah. So that's how it works. So how does it work if you... How does the structure work if you work with dance music? So what I did, I imported... I didn't want to deal with copyright. So what I did, I imported a song of myself, which I made 4, 5, 6 years ago. And it's dance music, it's techno. And what I want to do is I want to play through it. And I want to analyze with you what is the structure and how does it work, you know? And by doing that, I want to show you and give you a method or a way for you to do it yourself. Because this came out of this. That's how I made that song. First I made loops here, and then here I put them behind each other and I made a structure to build a song. So now let's listen to this together first to get an impression of how the song works, and then I will talk a little bit about it, how the structure was built. And again, it was made in Ableton. I first made the parts here and then I made them play in the arrangement here. Yeah? Okay, let's listen. And I might talk a little bit through it. And I'm not going to play the whole 7 minutes. So we're going to scan a little bit through the song to give you an impression of how it works. So, the start. So some extra elements, and you hear it's very clearly loop based. I just play a little bit until here. Less energy. Little break. After break, you want to go back. So a bit more energy there. Extra ride. It's a 909 ride. Maybe you recognize it. Holding back the energy. So now it's still the same loop, but the loop is getting fuller and fuller, right? Now there's more low end, more bass energy there in that part. Now it goes into a break. So again, you lose the low end. And what's happening here in this part? You see, there's a little build up. It's a break, but the break is building a little bit up. More energy. This part is important. Let's give it a different color. Let's go a bit further. Extra clap, extra hi-hat. Same break almost as this break, but there's a little difference between this break and this break. Slowly a synthesizer is coming in. So it's all the same, but now a synthesizer is coming in as well. It's the analog, by the way. So it's the same loop as here, but with this clear, different instrument. Break again. The synth's in. More synth. So this is the whole song, and why I use this song, because it's so clear in how it's built up, and it's so clear that it all comes from one loop, and that might also be the way for you to do it the first time, especially when you've never done it before. You have your loop, and your loop might become the key, the core of this whole song, and that's what I want to show you by playing this. So how is it basically working? So basically I made some loops here when I made the song, and then at a certain point I went to this screen, but I made this red because this loop is the most full loop in this screen. So imagine that you have a build up here, maybe some drums, and then you get an extra bass, you get some extra hi-hats, you get some extra percussion. So it's building up until you have this very full loop, and this very full loop, this really condensed loop with a lot of information, that's this part of the song. And that's how I might have, I don't remember totally anymore, but how I might have made this song. So when I made the song, I didn't start there and then I was like, oh, let's do a build up. No, maybe I started in the middle. So I had this full loop, and we're going to do it in a second with a real loop. And maybe I just put it somewhere in the middle, and then I was like, okay, what's happening before? Because then you can take out instruments, like, oh, let's take out the low end here, you know? So let's go back. So this. Okay, let's go back. You see, you miss elements. You miss low end, look. Full and high clap. Extra hi-hats, but you can say, oh, there are extra hi-hats and there's an extra clap here, but you can also say here, everything is here, and I took out some stuff here, and still this is working, you know, but I took out some of those things, I took them out here, and when I go here, there's even less in there, yeah, so it's even a smaller amount of the instrument is playing here compared to there, and here it's just the bare minimum. Yeah, so if you build a song, a lot of people start building from the beginning, and then they're like, okay, how can I build this up? Okay, let's add something more. But in that way, sometimes it becomes too predictable. So what is an easier way? First, build your fullest stuff here, add a lot of stuff until you really like it, it's really full, then bring that to the middle, and then start to take instruments out and then put those parts before. So that's how you do the inverse of a build-up, and in the end, if you listen to it, it is a build-up. Yeah, so this is the core loop, and I think you hear it here as well. Ah, there's something on top of it. So you say that's the same loop. The only thing what happened after the full loop, it became maybe a little bit boring, so I introduced an extra element. So this whole part afterwards becomes different. And what did I introduce? You hear it in this break, you hear it coming in. Listen, here the synth is, in the beginning the synth is not there. It's just the rhythm. Extra clap. And now you go to the break, and then I introduce a new element. It's very soft now. It's coming in. That one. Yeah. So this synthesizer that is coming in is defining the whole second part of the song. There it is. Boom, and going on. So it's the same part as here, but now with the synthesizer. And then what I did is in this, after this, I even started to play more with the synth. So the synth even starts to draw more attention. And more percussion, but listen to the synth. It's just the analog. Or just the analog. Break. That's the synth. It's the same synth. There it goes. So, what is happening? This stuff is still playing here. You know, this stuff is still, it's still playing there. But the only thing that is extra is the synth. And that makes this whole part interesting. You see? So you make a loop. We say undress in Dutch, but that's a bit weird. But that's how do you say it in Dutch? You take it in, take out instruments, you take more instruments out, you take more instruments out. That's how you build this structure, because you're taking it out. If you listen to it, it's a build up. And then at a certain point, when you have everything, you're like, okay, what can I do to bring this whole thing to a higher level? And what it was in this song was just adding another synthesizer, and this is just still playing, and then the synthesizer was starting to do its own thing, and that's what you listen to here. Here you don't listen to the loop anymore, but you listen more to the. To the synth, to the melody, yeah? Okay, so that's it. Now we're going to do it ourselves. I saved the little setup that I made last week. And probably you have also built a little setup. That was the assignment of last week. So if you haven't watched last week, just watch it now. And then after that, build this little setup. So I can play through it. What do we have? It's the remix, right? So first, it was just this part out of the song. And then it was this sample out of the song with extra drums, with an extra drum computer. And then it went to this. Same loop, but I transposed it up, so it's just playing higher, same drums there. Then we go to the third one, it's the same loop as there, you know, it's playing again, but there are some extra there's an extra tambourine coming in and a shaker, and then we go there. And the break is back to square zero. Yeah? Okay, so now I want to show you how you can transform this into a song. So we're just going to do it and think about what I said about the structure. Yeah? So how does it technically work? First of all, you can just copy paste stuff from this screen to the other screen. If I go here, you know, I can go up and down between the two screens. If you press the tab key, it does the same. And this tab key is pretty handy. For example, if I click on this, I can move it around. I can put it somewhere else. But if I now hold my mouse key while I press the tab key, now I'm here and I can just drop it somewhere here. For example, here. And then I can do like this and then it's looping. Yeah? You can do it also with more stuff. If you click on this one and you hold the shift key, you know, then I have, you see, I have both the clips, and now I press tab and I put it in the tracks where they come from, which was two and drums. So I go there and then you can make it longer. And there they are. It was track 2 and 4. That's what you need to remember. If you move stuff from here to the other screen, you have to put them in the right track. This one is coming from track 2, so that's there. This one is coming from track 1, 2, 3, 4, called drums. 1, 2, 3, 4, called drums. Yeah, so they need to go to their own track. Yeah? So how does this screen work? If you press twice the stop button, then the cursor starts in the beginning. So if I play now, oh, sorry, the other screen is still playing. Let's stop this stuff. This button stops everything here. Stop. So everything stopped. So if I press play now, you didn't hear anything because there's nothing here. And if you want to play from a certain point, you can click and then you play and it will play from there on. If you want to play from the start, you double click on the stop. It's there, you see the orange line and you can play it and it will start playing from there. It will also start recording from there. So in a second, we will record some stuff. It will record from the orange line. So if you want to record some extra stuff to this screen and you press here, you set the orange line here, then and you press record, then it will record from there. But most of the times you want to record from the beginning. You'll see it in a second. Zooming in and out, if I go up with the cursor, now it becomes a magnifying glass. If I click on the mouse key and I go down, I zoom in. If I go up, I zoom out. If I go left and right, then it goes like that. Yeah, so left, right, up, down. This is the loop. If you want to loop something, we'll see that in a second as well. What else? The volume and the mute button are the same as over here. So if I mute it, then it's also muted here. If I change the volume, then it's also, you see, minus 14. And here it's also minus 14. If I go up again to 0, then it wasn't 0. Let's do that. Now it's 0. There it's 0. Yeah. Some other things might come up, but then I will tell them and explain them then. So now what I want to do is I want to play this stuff. And while I'm playing it, I want to record it here so that it will show up here. So how does it work? First, I press display because then this is the beginning of the song. So this one is activated. It's my beginning. That's good. Now I want to record from the beginning here. So I all the time when I go up and down, by the way, it's the tab key. Yeah? Or you do it there. So I press stop twice because then the cursor will go to the beginning, and then when I record, I will record from the beginning. So stop, it's there, and now I'll press record or record, I never know, and then I will just start playing the music and it will be recorded in the other screen. Okay, so let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the beginning. You see, it's being recorded now because this one is playing. And now I'll press that one. Go next one. You can follow your own gut feeling with the tempo and back. Since everything is recorded here. Break. Okay, so it's recording everything that you're doing. Also, if you would start to move some sliders, like the volume slider, or if you would move some buttons on your effects, everything will be recorded here. If you want to record something extra now in this thing, it's very simple. So if I would say, okay, but here I want to record this scene, so this one. Yeah, this part. I want to record it here. You just press record and this is playing. You see, and it will just start popping up. Okay. Undo, edit, undo, record. if you fucked up, you can just do like this, and then while you go to edit and you do select all, and you delete, then it's all gone. Undo. So, okay. The most difficult knob, the most difficult button of Ableton, that's this one. This button, it's orange now. If this button is orange, it will show, or it tries to tell us that in this screen something is playing, but in this screen something else is playing. So there's a difference in what is playing between this whole screen and that. Because in this screen, only these two clips are playing, the rest is not switched on, right? So track 3 and 4 are active, they are playing. And in this screen, track 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sorry, everything is active. So there's a difference between the two. And Ableton, in that case, will always play this screen. So it won't play this. So if I now press, put the cursor somewhere and I press play, actually, I'm not hearing this one. Look, nothing happening there, nothing happening there. Only these two, 3 and 4. And that is because it's just playing this. So if I stop this one, you see, this is not playing anymore. It's still running here, but I don't hear this. So per default, Ableton is always playing what is happening here. And it might be nothing, but still it's doing that. If you want to hear what's going on in this screen, you can, boom. The colors will change, which mean that they become active, and the button is gone now. So now you will hear this stuff. Yeah. So this is what I just did here. It's now in this screen. Yeah, so that's the first step for you. This is the extra thing that came in. You see it here. It goes on, and now this thing is coming in, and this thing. And we go to the break. So for me, this buildup feels natural. And why is that? It is because I think it's built up every difference. So every step in this buildup takes 4 bars. You see, it starts with 1. Then 4 bars later, 4 bars later, 4 bars later, 4 bars later, 4 bars later. If you would do this differently, and I can show you how that will sound. So let's take out, for example, this, and let's take out here 2. So I'm going to mess it up a little bit, but so now the buildup is not 4 bars anymore. You see, this is 4 bars, but this it's too short, and this one is even shorter, and this one is short. Let's listen now how it feels. That's a bit hard to hear because there's no tempo. Yeah, so it doesn't sound logical, it doesn't make sense. Especially, I remember when I started with this, I was like, yeah, fuck it, basically. I was like, yeah, that's I don't want to work with a recipe, you know, so I will just make this shorter, make that longer. And that's fine, you can do whatever you want. But if you feel a little bit lost, and you're like, okay, my structure is not really feeling natural, then it might help to look if your buildup works with steps that are or 4 bars long, or like twice 4 bars. It can also be 8 bars, you know, this could also be double. So let's double the whole thing. It might be a bit boring, but it will sound logical. Just listen this steps from there to there to there. Let's, so it's boring, but listen if it feels logical and natural. DC, it's a very natural and logical transition. It's boring, maybe, it's too long, but it's not about that now. Yeah? I might even prefer this than the one that I had before. Because it gives a feeling of like a, we say rest in Dutch, so it feels stable. Okay, let's go back what we had. Okay, now let's work with this. So now you have your loop, you moved it to this part of the screen. How does this screen work? So if you want to delete something, you're like, okay, but I don't like the hi-hats here, then you can just do delete backspace, so it's out. Yeah, another thing, if you double click, it will show you the notes that are in there. Yeah, it has nothing to do anymore with what is here. It's now disconnected. If you click on this and you change something here, it's not changed here, it's only changed here. So for example, if I do extra clap, watch there what happens. You see, it's showing up there. And it stops here. You know, it didn't change here because this is separated, you see, from the other one. So if you change something below, now I'm going to take them away and you will see it again. It only happens in the one that you selected. So for example, if I want to change something here and not here, then I can't, because if I do it here, you see it happens there as well. You see it happens on the left and the right. So if I want to change something only in a certain part, what I have to do, so if I want to change only something over here, I have to split it. I have to separate it from the rest. So how does it work? I click and I go to edit and I do split. Everything is an edit today. You see, and now it's disconnected. So if I now put like 100 claps, which sounds crazy, you know, it's only happening there. Yeah. So, okay, let's undo. And you see the shortcut is Apple Z. Okay, there we are. And even undo the split. So now it's one thing again. Yeah, so that's how it works. Yeah. What else? Oh yeah, the deleting I just showed you. You just hit backspace. But sometimes you want to delete a part. So for example, I'm like, okay, I really don't like this part. Which is playing here. I just want to get rid of the whole thing. So there are different ways to do it. The first one is with the shift button. You hold the shift and you can select more. And now I can press backspace. It's gone. Another thing, what you can do is this. You click on one of the parts of it, only one, not everything, and then you go to edit and you say loop my selection. What it will do then, you see the loop that was here is moving. Oh, so I select it and I say loop selection. And now the loop is being put around this. And if I click on the loop now, it will select everything. And if I press delete, everything is gone. Yeah. But now we have a problem because it's playing here. And I want to go after this, I want to go there. But now we have a silence. Oh, you know, that's not really, it's maybe very creative, but yeah, I would like to go there straight after this. So what you do then is, let's undo this first. You click on the loop again, yeah? Remember, so you click on this and then you do edit loop selection. The loop is now, so you click on the loop, so everything is selected. And now you don't do delete, but you do delete time. So look what happens on the right. Poof, this one moves to the left. Yeah, one more time. So this one will move to the left because the whole time is deleted. Delete time. There it is. Yeah. So these are like the most important tools to copy paste and edit. Well, basically the copy pasting is really simple. Edit, you do copy and you go somewhere and you say edit paste. And one more, edit, paste. Yeah. Another one, another thing that you might do is just take the right border and then you drag it and it'll just go on and on and on and on, and on because it's a loop. Another thing is the, and I use this button a lot, duplicate, Apple D. So you can say Apple D, or first do it like this, duplicate, you get an extra one. Or you use the shortcut, Apple D, Apple D, Apple D, Apple D. And I like that because you can, you remember what I said in the beginning here, if I did copy paste this to there, that also happens here. Let's listen one more time to what we have. Oh no, first let's listen to the break. I switch on the metronome. It suddenly stops. That's weird. So I'm going to use four bars. So from 21 to 25. If you hold shift, you select more and then let's make them longer. So now it's a nice natural length here. Boom, 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 boom. And that's it. Okay, now let's listen one more time from the beginning. And my question to you is, what are we listening to? If you, which part of a song are we hearing now? This clearly is the intro, right? Yeah. So what I hope is that by listening to it, and maybe sometimes you have to close your eyes because you sometimes it's distracting what you see, because when you listen to this until this whole part, you might think, oh, that's four parts because I say one, two, three, four. So this is four parts. But actually what I think is what we are hearing is only one part of the song. So this whole thing is one part. So again, if I do loop selection, now my whole loop is around it and it's a whole part. Yeah, it's not four parts. So imagine it's a band, you know, they're just playing. Yeah, this is one part. Let's listen to it again. Then it plays on. Yeah. So let's get into the copy pasting. I'm a big fan of that if you work with this kind of stuff, because you can build a structure pretty quickly. So let's take this whole thing, select it, and then we say duplicate. And if you duplicate it, it would duplicate it on top of what is here, but I want this to move to the right. So then you do, I just showed you delete time, now we're going to do duplicate time, so it will move this to the right. So boom, there we go. So we have an intro, I'm not going to play it, so this is the intro, and this actually, and I will give it a color, is for me one part. Yeah, so it's not eight parts. No, it's one part. It takes 1 minute. Yeah, and it goes on. Okay. So that's important. You can use this duplication and you have to sometimes change your mindset that you're not listening to four parts or four loops or whatever. No, this is one musical part. And this is always the difficult part when people start to do songwriting, because they're like, yeah, it's boring. Fuck. Olaf, what the fuck are you telling us? It's just fucking boring. I'm going to quit. And that happens a lot. A lot of people say, yeah, I have like a lot of ideas, and but I never finish them. And that's sometimes because you think it's boring, so I quit. It's not good. And that's what I want to show you now. So there are tricks, and I'll show you a trick in a second. But the first thing what you can do, just listen to it and then be honest, like, okay, now it's getting boring. So probably maybe here, already a little bit here, but that's easy to fix, I think. When you hear it the second time, it's like, yeah, again. So then it gets boring, but that doesn't mean that it's wrong or you have to start doing a new song. No, you just have to, I'm going to close these things. So it's a bit, you do it with the triangle. That's also, so you can also open it up, you know, if you want to see what's in there. Now you have to become creative. So how can we make this interesting after hearing this? So if this would be a band and there would be a synthesizer player and a drum player, maybe here we're going to say right mouse click, the extra bass player comes in. So how are we going to do that? So I selected it, and then you say insert MIDI clip. And now we're going to add an instrument. Let's try something. The bass. I have no clue how they sound. I never know. And let's find the bass. This sounds horrible. Change the volume a bit. Huh? You can also do it here. So you just make a bass line. It's not the best bass line I ever made. Duplicate this, edit, duplicate, Apple D, and then with the arrows move it to the right. Now this whole thing, duplicate. Select the tool with shift and duplicate. And here maybe we make a little variation. Boom, boom, dum, da dum, dum dum. And maybe make the sound a little bit nicer with a delay. So let's see how it works. You come from here. Oh, again, if you want to play from somewhere. So here's the magnifying glass. If you go a bit down, you get a speaker. If I click now, it will play from there. Yeah. Another thing that you can do to make it more spicy is maybe put an effect. So this is the main loop. Yeah, and we can filter it, right? Yeah, so maybe this is the other loop. I can just record it. So let's start a little bit before when the bass comes in. And maybe I want to make this more exciting. So maybe here I will filter it, that it becomes more dull. So you take out energy. And then here, the other loop will play, which is not filtered. So let's put a filter. Oh, it's already there. So let's record. Yeah. So now, if I play it, it shows you what I did. Yeah. So you see now that this part, it became a bit boring, and you make it less boring, or in the end you want to make it really nice. And I'll show you one more thing to keep it going, but it's still, this is the basic. Remember when I showed you the techno song, you had the basic thing, which is this, and you make that more interesting, but this carries the song. So I think it's still a bit boring. The bass is not something that is like an eye catcher. So let's create another track and maybe add a nice sound. And now I'm going to actually play it with my keyboard. I have to look for the... Shit, I had it going. Okay, let's record it. So I just played it on my keyboard. It's just, you know, the keyboard of your computer. And I will make mistakes. And I always just play a little, and I'm like, okay, this is not too bad, so I keep that. And let's make it sound a bit better. It's a bit boomy, so I make a high pass. And maybe put a reverb on top of it. Yeah, and let's see how that comes in. Maybe it has to come in a little bit early, because I played a bit early. So here we go with the whole parts. We come from the other side. Now we go to the break. Yeah, and maybe that break can be twice as long. And then, now we say after that, after the break, you go back. Remember, like the pop song. So if you're first, then you have your chorus, and after the chorus you go back to the verse. So let's take this whole thing, put the loop around it, around the whole part, go to edit, say copy, and now we put the cursor here and we say edit, paste, boom. And now we already have a song of 2.5 minutes. Yeah, and we're working only for 30 minutes. And then probably after that, I can even predict we hear this. So let's hold shift, select the whole thing, edit, copy, go there, edit, paste, pats. So now we have like the big chunk of the song is there. Yeah? It won't be perfect, totally not, but I just want to show you how you can quickly build like a main structure. And after that, it's adding little things. So let's listen one more time. I'm not going to play the whole song. I'll skip through it. So it starts with the intro. And you know, I'm already thinking, like for example, on this one, you know, this sound, listen. I put this reverb, right? So if you think about consistency, I might want to copy that and then go there to the other track, which plays the breaks, this sound, and just paste it there. So it gives some consistency. So this reverb is now there. Okay, now we get this part, right? Let's go. Let's take this. I skip a little bit. The filter. Let's copy this with the filter. So I copy the whole thing, copy, and I put it here, paste. So now you will see the filter doing it again, this, because it's copying the line. Break, and maybe in the break we take out the kick. So there, kick. Delete. So then it goes there. That's the drums. Okay. That's not the best, but it's okay. It's okay. And okay. What I notice now when I hear it, I build up energy here, then you have to break, and then you don't want to go all the way back to the beginning. So you want to go back to that part again. So this chunk, this one, the first half needs to go. So delete time, boom. So you go there, to the break, that's where I took out the kick. Kick coming in. Yeah. Okay. And maybe another way to take a little bit of the energy out, because you cannot always go up with energy. So sometimes you have to go back with energy. One trick is to go there and then I select all the notes that I played and I take them an octave down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, that's not working. Man, different, so do select all. So now all the notes are selected. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You see, it's much lower. So let's see how that goes. Yeah, that works. Yeah. Copy that again, put it there. Filter goes down. Yeah, I can show you one more thing. So we took this filter, right? I'll solo it, then you hear it. So I record it, remember? I record it and I just turn the knob. This, and you see it there. It might be nice to also do it on the drums. So you can just copy this whole thing. So again, copy. And then go to the different track, to the drums. So it's a different track and then paste. Now look. Oh, sorry. So when this is playing, I can even right mouse show automation, then you see it. You see? You get the same. So now the drums will also become more filtered. Let's see if that works. Better. And you can even draw the line. It will open up. Yeah, if you want to draw that line so you can record it. If I double click, I get an extra circle and then I can move it. If I double click, it goes away again. You can also use the pencil and then you can draw it like that. That will, I want to hear that. Look. Click. Boom. Okay. And that's it. And I think that's a nice ending for today. So, again, just try this out. So first of last week, do what we did last week. So build a little build up here and then record it here or just copy paste it here. And then try to listen to it and try to listen it to it and try to identify the different parts. And the parts are not just the visual chunks, they are bigger. And when you have that, I want to hear them twice, you know, just play them twice. And then if it sounds boring, don't let that hold you back. Like, oh no, I cannot play it twice. No, you can, but then you have to add some stuff, make it more interesting. And then you get a big chunk and that's a part of a song. This is a part. And then you go to the different part, right? Which was only this thingy there. And then you go back to there. And then I notice like, oh fuck, you still kind of need this energy, but maybe you can change it a bit. So I can take out some energy. That is not all the time a linear buildup of energy. Yeah, this is not easy, but just play with it. Don't expect to write, make it too difficult or too hard on yourself. Just try to make a little part of a song. And if you want to really go for it, try to make a whole song. Then you finish your remix. But if you just make one part that works a bit like this, then that's already fantastic. All right. So that's the assignment for this week. So finish this arrangement. This is called an arrangement for this week. If you have any questions, put them below the video or put them in the WhatsApp group. And then next week we will go on with the course. So thank you for listening. Bye.